2015, when I first came to know that I was suffering from CKD, which is a chronic kidney disease, I was 22 weeks pregnant that time. And then I met Dr. Rohan and went through all the tests. And when it was confirmed that, yes, I'm suffering from a kidney disease, and that was the point when I had to, we had to abort the child.
So it was quite a difficult task for a young lady looking forward to being a mother, and here we are telling her to terminate pregnancy and go on dialysis. We then realized that her kidney disease is quite advanced and beyond the point of repair. And then finally, we had to take the call and put her on dialysis. And around 2 years of ups and downs, but she sailed through, and if I would put it, she was always the single patient, always smiling on dialysis, no matter what.
After 2 years of dialysis, I had to move to Pune due to my husband's job. Within few months, I realized that the dialysis which was happening there was not good, or I was not getting dialyzed properly. So that's when we decided to come back to Bangalore and meet Dr. Rohan again.
When I saw her again, she came back with a lot of swelling in both her upper limbs. And when we took her history, we realized that she had these catheters stuck down her neck, and these were gradually narrowing down over a period of time. I had an honest discussion with her, saying I can keep her going for now, but it is very important that she has a plan for the future. It may not be an indefinite dialysis like this. This was virtually a race against time. We were losing accesses, and we somehow wanted her to get a transplant. And that is when, as a ray of hope, her brother came forward.
Hey, तुमको वो टी-शर्ट भेजे थे कैसा लगा?
और कोई कलर नहीं मिला था तुमको?
येलो फेवरेट कलर है ना मेरा.
And the operation was successful, and now it has been 1 year. I am fit and fine. There are things which I was not able to do earlier. So because of this health issue, there was a point when I had to leave my job. Now today I am searching for work, and even that is because Dr. Rohan, after 4 to 6 months, he told me, go back to work. Why are you sitting at home? Now it's time you should come back to your normal life. And I can say, yes, I am physically fit. I am active. I can move around. I can go wherever I want. I can eat whatever I want. I can drink whatever I want. So I am a tea coffee lover. So I can take as much cups of coffee I want. The support system, that matters a lot. There might be people who leave you, but then my family was there, my husband. Every point he was there, whether I'm shouting at him, I'm cribbing on anything, I'm crying, he was always there with me.
I know that she needed that emotional support from my side. That is what I provided all the time. Whenever she was low, I used to give her a boost up. Whenever I was low at certain times, even though she was in pain, then she used to boost me up that, okay, we will sail it through. And that's how the entire journey we sailed through strongly. And now that it's a new sun life for all of us.
We at Manipal have a wonderful team set up by Dr. Balal, and we are a team of around 7 to 8 nephrologists. So we were confident on our abilities that we would be able to pull this off. There was debates because of her weight issues whether we should offer her robotic transplants versus conventional. We went ahead with the transplant, and she was very keen to wipe the slate clean. So 2018 end, I told her, we'll try for the transplant the next year. She said, no, I want to start the new year on a clean slate.
And today when I look back, I feel that, yes, I'm a strong woman, that I have faced many things and still I'm standing.
We have around 10 to 15 deaths per day of patients who are on dialysis awaiting a kidney transplant. While there are only around 3,500 transplants being done per year in our country, and this is a story wherein we would want to tell the public that organ donation is virtually safe, and it would go a long way in giving a life to your loved ones.
I would request everyone watching this video, please register yourself to be an organ donor so that you can save somebody's life.